Salut, ce faci? Sloposim-aș pe tine, eh? Ți-a făcut pula? Ah, da, știu. Okay, hey guys, Hector Castillo, Poppy from girlshace.com. Obviously, we're going to talk about dirty talk today. I just did some dirty talk in Romanian. It's probably one of the funnest languages to talk shit and talk dirty in because it's so raw and very explicit with the way that they express themselves. So, we're going to go into how to actually dirty talk verbally, like vocally with your voice, because that's super important. I'll go into that. How to hold frame when you're talking dirty so that you come off confident and it really gets her wet and she believes what you're saying. And then what to actually say in words themselves and how do you communicate this sexy, fantastical world to her while you're in bed with her and in sexual congress with her. So, first thing. You need to have a sexy voice. You need to develop this resonance and depth and warmth and purr that makes your voice sexy so that when you say it to her, you're not like, "You like that dick?" You know, "Does it feel good, chica? Yeah, okay." Right, you need to be sexy with like, "You like that dick, girl? Yeah, you're such a good girl for daddy. There you go." That's sexy. So if you need help with that, actually, instead of going into some long explanation, pause the video and go right here or check out the link in the description for my video on how to have a sexy voice. It is absolutely necessary. You're not gonna have any fun with any of this shit if you sound like a fucking gremlin and you're trying to talk shit in her ear. Because basically, dirty talk is talking shit to a girl like, "I'm so cool and I'm fucking that pussy, and you're lucky to be getting this dick." That is the basis of dirty talk. It's talking shit, but with a sexual element and a romantic element. And when you're doing that, you have to sound fucking confident and masculine. But if you don't have a masculine voice, then it's not gonna fucking do its job. And you're gonna actually have the opposite effect. And she's probably gonna look at you like, you know, something seriously wrong with you. So get a sexy voice. And then what you have to do is you're gonna have to practice, right? So at some point, you're gonna have to say something dirty. I remember when I first learned how to talk dirty, I was a bit nervous and I thought it was silly. In the same way that I think role playing is silly. Like, I can act pretty well, but I don't know if I could like go through a role play scenario without cracking up because it's just like too obvious that we're fucking around. But when I first started dirty talking, it was almost like, why do I have to say this? Because like we're already having sex, isn't this hot enough? But then eventually I learned that, oh, I can go into this. Dirty talk is really hot for women because it's the same reason that I always talk about how women read porn rather than watch it. I mean, obviously, girls don't mind watching a gangbang here and there, but women do definitely prefer to read it because they're more interested in the experience of the seduction. And so sex is just the culmination of the seduction. Whereas for guys, it's kind of like, "We just want sex, give us sex." For the woman, it's a bit of an experience, and sex just happens to be the top of the pyramid. And when you talk dirty, what it does is you continue the seduction that you were doing at the drink table, you know, at the bar, and you were talking to her with a sexy voice, and you know, you were talking about your life and your passions, and you were touching her, and there's this energy of sexuality, and it's fun, and it's romantic, and it's sexy. So you continue that in the bedroom. Yes, she's wet. Yes, she's taking your dick, and she's having a good time. But how you take it from here to here is you give her the full experience and you continue the seduction through the sex. The seduction never stops. It's happening before sex, during sex, and after sex. So while you're in the bed with her, continue to seduce her with your words and talk dirty in a sexy voice, and it's gonna drive her absolutely wild. Now, in order for her to buy into this fantasy and for her to believe that she's in this situation with this really hot guy who knows how her mind works and knows how to give her an amazing experience where she's very submissive and you're very dominant because you're leading. That's what dominant means. You're getting what you want and you're leading. You're leading the seduction. You're leading the sexual experience. And so when you give her that confidence and that assurance through your voice, not only because it's sexy, that's what turns her on, but then you have to actually be confident with it. And if you're not confident with it, you can say something and you're like, "You like that dick?" And it could just be the slightest hesitance in your voice that's going to, I mean, she's gonna enjoy it, right? She's not gonna be like, "You stuttered, so get your dick out of my pussy," right? She's gonna enjoy it, but it's not going to drive her wild as if you were super confident, like a guy who's done this before. And it's like, yeah, you like being a whore for daddy? Mm-hmm. Yeah, good girl. That's what's gonna drive her crazy, because you're confident, you believe what you're saying. And how you get people into your stories is you're confident in your stories. Most of the time, we like to think of ourselves as rational, but we're just emotional beings who have a small capacity for rationale. It's a quote from Jed McKenna, if you guys wanna check him out. But basically, we backwards rationalize our lives. We do things emotionally and then we think about them afterwards usually. So when you're being persuasive with someone, this is with storytelling, with seduction, or with sex, you have to make them believe that you know what the fuck you're talking about. We always go with the guy who's most confident, even though he might not be right, and it's got humanity into like horrible situations where someone acts like they know what they're talking about, but they don't because they're persuasive and they're confident. So you can use this to a positive benefit and have her enjoy the seduction much more because you are confident in the fact that she's enjoying this, that she does like that big dick in her tight pussy, and she does like getting dominated, and she is a fucking slut for you, right? That is the truth, and it comes off like the truth because you're actually persuasive about what the fuck you're talking about, and she believes you. So one guy could be like, yeah, you like being my slut? And she's like, what? Motherfucker, don't talk to me like that. Or another guy, this big pimping dude, he's like, yeah, you like that dick, you little slut? She's like, yes, I love that dick. In a really deep, gravelly voice. Oh man, I remember this one time, this chick, she was really pretty, but she was a bodybuilder. And so she was quite masculine. And she was taller than me, and she was physically bigger than me. I was stronger because I'm a man, but she was in good shape, but very muscular. Took her home. I remember she did the fucking arch like this. She didn't even know how to like do this because she was used to fucking girls from the softball team, you know, lesbians. But I bent her over, and so she's like this, and I'm fucking her. I'm like, all right, she has a great ass, and you know, she's got some nice skin, and so she's hot. But then she opened her mouth, and she was like, yeah, I like that. I'm like, oh no. I think I'm fucking a man with a pussy. She was definitely a woman, you know, but it was definitely an interesting experience. So that just goes to show you that the tone of your voice is very important when you're talking dirty to a girl in bed, because it can break the seduction if you're not being sexy. So for the woman, if you want to talk dirty, you got to be, oh, I should go into a video about that and how to teach girls how to talk dirty. For any female viewers, and we actually have a decent amount of female viewers, so I'll go into that really quick just as a bonus to you beautiful little ladies. If you want to talk dirty in bed, you want to be, okay, here's the trick. Be slutty for the sake of being slutty. Don't be slutty because you want us to get turned on. We know. It's kind of like we usually know when you're faking it. If we have any empathy at all, we can tell if you're faking how much you're enjoying it. We can also tell when you're talking dirty just to talk dirty. We want you to talk dirty because you want to feel like a slut and you're enjoying it. Like, be a whore for you. And so if you're saying like, oh, Poppy, I love that dick, say it because you're really liking that dick. And go crazy, be in your own world and allow yourself to get lost in the sex and just say what comes to mind, even if it's really dirty and really gross. Because if you're being a slut for yourself, it's gonna seem genuine and it's not gonna seem like you're just a porn actress who's acting, because I've had girls do that. You know, they're screaming like, ah. I'm like, look, my dick is great. And we'll get to the point where you're going like that. But I just put it in, like, there's no way you're that horny for me. And so it kind of breaks the spell, because I can know when girls are like very experienced with guys, so they know how to seduce them. But with someone who also knows game, they can see right through it like fucking thin paper. And I'm like, yeah, that's, you're just acting. That's super unattractive. So for girls, if you're gonna talk dirty, yeah, give me that big dick, yeah, blah, 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 anything like that, do it because you wanna feel that sexuality and you wanna feel like a dirty slut. Don't do it for us. And then we're gonna enjoy it the most. Okay, but back to guys. So when you're talking dirty to a girl, sexy voice, be confident. Now, what do we actually talk about? We want to talk about my dominance over you, so how small you are and how big I am, either me or my dick. Even if you don't have the big dick, just fucking go for it. Just say you got some monster dick. Just give her the illusion of being fucked by a big dick. It's going to help if you have a hard dick. And actually, we have a video on how to have a rock hard erection right here, and it's in the description below. And it's gonna give her the experience of you being big and hard. Also, you can use your body language to be big and hard. Use positions that make you big and dominant and overlapping and make her go into positions where she's small and vulnerable and weak, and that's gonna make her feel more feminine. And I have a video for that as well right here and in the description below. So talk about your dick and her pussy and how small and tight it is and how big and hard you are. Talk about her sexuality, so how big of a slut she is for you. The biggest thing is call her your slut. There's a big difference between calling her a slut and calling her your slut. It's actually like that one word added to it is huge, because you don't want to call her a slut in general. I mean, yeah, you can be like, oh, you're such a dirty little slut, but the implication should be for me. Like, you're a slut for me. You're unleashing your sexuality on me. And that makes me focus my sexuality on you. So that's the undertone that you want. And you can also just add the verbal aspect to it. Like, you're my slut. You like being my little whore. You wanna focus on body parts. Like, she's got a great ass. She's got great tits. You know, I like watching your tits bounce. It's like, fuck that pussy really hard. Be very, 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 very vulgar. This is not a time for political correctness or any sort of sensibilities whatsoever. You just need to be raw and primal and very degrading. When it comes to the bedroom, most women, vast majority, I don't care if you have one or two exceptions, most women that I've seen like just being railed and ravished and degraded in bed. For various reasons. We can go into the psychology of it, but women really like to be degraded in bed because they want to feel controlled, that you're in control of them. So yeah, control of them. That's another thing that you want to talk about. So how this is going to play out. So when you're talking about members, look, you like my big hard dick and that tight little pussy. Tight, you see I'm using that language, tight. Small. If you have an interracial situation going on, you can add the element of your different skin tones. That can add some fetishes to it if you're into that or she's into it. If she's, you know, very much more petite than you and was much more submissive in the seduction than you, you can also add in elements of the seduction. So like, oh yeah, when I was at dinner, I was, you know, I kept, when I went to the bathroom, I saw like your cute little ass sitting there on the chair and I just wanted to fuck you and I can't wait to get you home. You know, if she was wearing a dress that looked sexy, I was like, oh, you know, I was just waiting to lift that skirt up and see if you were even wearing underwear. And you can say this while you're fucking her because you want to talk about the seduction itself, like it leading up to the sex. Because like I said, the seduction happens before, during, and after sex. And so you want to talk about the seduction while you're in sex, because what you're saying is, look, I got you here. I dominated you. So you're getting into her and you're talking in a sexy voice. You want to be close to her. You can say it in her ear. That's the best way, is when you're just in her ear and you're talking like this. That's really hot because it's very intimate. It's just for her. And also, you want to add your sexy voice, but add a little bit of demonic flair to it. I would say yeah, you like that dick. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're such a sexy little girl. It's super cringy right now. I know. You're watching this video and you're like, that was so fucking cringy. I can't believe it. But when you're in the bedroom, it's going to play out. I promise, because again, there's no room for shame in the bedroom. It actually should be a place of the opposite. You should be totally allowing your freak flags to fly, and you need to just unleash all of the deep, dark, fucked up shit that's happening in your mind. So the seduction, body parts, how much she likes it. You know, you love that fucking big dick, don't you, Lou? And get her involved in it so you can use questions. Like, some girls complain, like, I hate when guys ask me if I like it. Yeah, but if you're talking dirty, like, yeah, you like that dick, you little slut? And then she's like, yeah, daddy. Also, the daddy thing, I like to do the poppy thing, obviously, as you've seen from these videos. Daddy is good. If you're super crazy, you can go into the master-slave dynamic. One that I almost forgot to talk about, and it's one of my favorites, is actually to sweet talk her. But you do it with dirty language. So you like being a little girl for daddy? You're such a good little girl. But you're saying it with like this mischievous, demonic voice, and you're like whispering in her ear, like, oh, you're such a good little slut, Bobby. Mm-hmm. You're so good. I'm gonna give you some spankings later. You know, you're such a good girl. Oh yeah, take that. And you're just fucking going like fucking deep as fucking hard as shit, and you're just fucking the shit out of her. But you're saying the nicest things, like, you're so sweet. Oh, you can even do that voice too. I like doing that. Is you contrast the sweetness with how hard you're going, and I do kisses on the cheek. I'm like, oh, you're so good. Yeah, you're such a good girl. And she's like, it's fucking great. It's amazing. It's awesome, and it makes her feel loved. But at the same time, ravished and totally degraded. And it's a beautiful combination. So body parts, body fluids, your cum, her wetness. Oh, you're so wet for daddy's big dick, aren't you? Yeah, you're such a good, fucking go crazy, be creative. You can practice on your own, like just think of things that sound hot. Sometimes you're gonna embarrass yourself and you're gonna like stutter. You're gonna be like, yeah, you like that. Dick. You're gonna be like, what should I say? Or you're gonna like sound like a fucking porno. You'd be like, you like that big rock hard cock in your tight cunt. You're gonna say something that is so cringy, but it's usually actually sometimes gonna turn out to be okay, because she knows, like, she's not expecting you to Shakespeare her fucking pussy with some beautiful, you know, dirty talk. She expects it to be raw and sometimes lame and sometimes cheesy, but the most important thing is talk with that sexy voice, a deep voice or a sweet voice, but also be confident. You gotta sell it. You know, if you stutter, who cares? Keep fucking going. I've been fucking Forrest Gump a few times while I was talking dirty in a girl's ear, but you just keep going because it's a seduction. Just like in a seduction, and when a mistake happens, you keep fucking piling on and you keep talking to her. If you fuck up during dirty talk, just keep talking, just act like it didn't happen and keep fucking her and make her forget it by slapping her in the face or something. Consensually, of course. Okay, cool. That was dirty talk. Be sexy, talk about dirty, raw, primal things. Don't hold back, be crude, be rude, and degrade the shit out of her because that's what she wants. But you can also be cute, and at the same time, you're fucking her pussy really hard with your rock hard cock. Cool. Hector Castillo, Poppy from girlschase.com. Hope you enjoyed the video. Follow me on social media. Check out, oh yeah, if you have problems even getting to sex, right? You can't really use this video if you're not getting laid. We have a great product called One Date. It's in the description below. And it teaches you how to meet a girl, take her on a date, get her home, fuck her, and turn her into your girlfriend, who then you can then use to use your dirty talk on her and apply the tips that you found in this video, because you gotta get laid before you can use them. So yeah, One Date, description below. Also, I got a book in there. It's great. Check it out. Free 7-day mini course. We got tons of shit in the description below. Just scroll down and you'll find a bunch of fun stuff. And yeah, Hector Castillo, Poppy, girlschase.com. Like, subscribe, ring the bell. Fuck you. Bye.